cards.
Thank you.
How many councillors have got some trouble?
Well, I'm prepared to say that 146,000 households in one, okay, and 30, I've been proud to say 38,000 of them who have subscribed. So that's how many subscribe. So
really good story, whether you update the panels. Everything's gone through microphone, please? Thank you.
Denise, you repeat that with the mic on, don't you?
Would you please update the council in regard to how we are making our young people ready for work at our time?
Next question is Councillor Johnson.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Mayor. Question for Councillor Tony Smith for Children and Family Services. Can the Cabinet member report on where regarding the safeguarding of children in the authority, please?
Okay, thank you, Councillor Smith.
Thank you, Councillor. Thank you for questions. It's always extremely useful to come back to the Council on the particular areas. So, this is the opportunity to talk about young people. We just recently had the LEAP results, which are young people up in education and training, and what proportion of young people who are LEAPs have reduced from 2013-14, which is a big result. Partner for Education recently published the national 3-month LEAP performance rate, and growth rate is 5.7%.
Councillor Smith, can you speak a little closer to the mic?
Oh, sorry.
You yeah. Use example of it here.
I do apologize.
Thank you.
The area where I was extremely pleased about was children in care and viability. Because I think we've certainly, over the years, tried to improve the situation here. In 2011-12, when Oxford came into the authority, council performance in relation to care leaders progressing into employment, education and training, aged 19, 37%. That was against a national benchmark of 58%. The latest data in 2013-14 is 66%. And this is a 29% improvement, which is important. And this is mainly done by the interventions, including intensive one-to-one coaching, mentoring, and delivery of the sport and viability program. As corporate parents, I think we are all here in this council chamber responsible for children in care. So this is an absolutely excellent improvement. But none of this can happen, Mr. Mayor. We have to work beforehand. And the early years work that is done in this authority, it's good to see an increased trend here. And the percentage of children achieving a good level of development this year has increased by 16% to 63%. It's still, you know, we can't be complacent about this. We've got to have a very high target. Certainly of the mind that by 2016, and I said this to numbers of groups, that at the very least we should have 86% of our young people, our early years children, in that kind of position. And again, I don't want to sort of label it, but key stage one, key stage two, again, we've had good results, an increase in the level two and key stage one. Again, the percentage of children looked after achieving level two in speaking, listening, reading, writing and maths has increased with the national average, and that's good. And then again, at key stage two, we've had what for me is the most pleasing aspect is the percentage of looked after children achieving reading and writing, and that has increased. Now, although in mathematics, the claim has decreased, and we'll be certainly looking at the reasons for that. Up to date, because of GCSE, we haven't had the final validation of the data, but what I can say is that in this authority, as far as I can see, it's probably the second highest in the Northwest
present time, we do not have any funding to continue this type of project in 2015-16. How is it proposed to support Wirral residents with their transport needs in the coming years?
Councillor Smith.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. This red pot also sends shivers down my spine. The number of potholes repaired represents about 5% of the total programme expected to be delivered by the end of the financial year. Can Stuart Whittingham, can